So it's not much of a game with just one scenario and one choice to make. So let's add a bit more story. Let's say that the old crone's house is in the middle of a forest. So let's add a bit more story. Now let's have our next choice. So let's call it choice two in our code comment. Now, let us have more than two decisions this time, because previously we only had two decisions, the R to run away or E to use magic. Let's have three this time. So we need to ask a new choice. So choice two equals input brackets. Press S to strike it, press K to kill it, or press R to run away. Okay? So we've got three possible outcomes here. S to strike it, K to kill it, or R to run away. Now, underneath, we need to write some code to deal with those three things. So let's say if choice two, let's say they pressed S to begin with. So make sure you've got that double equals, make sure you've got quotations around your S and a colon. Press enter, check for the indentation, and let's say what happens if you strike it. Now, the second one, you might be thinking, is it else? But actually, because we've got three of them, we can use what's called an ELIF. We can have as many ELIFs as we want, as long as we've got one IF and an ELSE at the top and the bottom, really, to clear up everything else. So an ELIF works exactly the same as an IF. So we say ELIF, choice two, equals, equals, K for killing it, and a quotation, and then we have our indented line, and we say... Now, if they haven't pressed S or K, we are going to write an else. Remember, the else doesn't need to be told what to do. So it's just else and a colon. So the else is R to run away. So we're going to say... Now, I've written quite a bit there, so I should probably use... triple quotation marks. There we go. To make it run. So the bunny is quicker than Nyx. Dot dot dot. And before you know it, it hops onto you. Dot dot. Reveals enormous fangs and bites your head off. Exclamation mark. Super. So we've now got three possible options to do. Now, I want it to lose a life every time the bunny manages to bite your head off. So you'd be pretty dead at that point. In our game, we're going to remove a life. So lives equals lives minus one to lose a life. And we're going to say that's the same here. Lives equals lives minus one, lose a life. However, this one, you kill the bunny. So we're going to give you a score increase. So score equals score plus five again, let's say. Add 5 points. Okay, super. Now we need to get to tell our adventurer how many points and lives they got. So remember this line from before, from our function, life score. We're going to just tuck that in at the end here, not indented, nicely up against the edge of the screen, and just get it to run that. Super. Well, let's test this game. Here we go again. Press S to strike it, K to kill it, or R to run away. Let's test each of the outcomes. Here comes S. Now, I didn't really write the end of my question very well, did I? Let's just amend that for next time. Say S. The bunny reveals enormous fangs and bites your head off. You have two lives left, because I lose a life here, and my score is 5. Now, before we run it again, let's just tweak this question here. So we're going to do a colon instead of a full stop and a space. Super. So we'll run it again. So we press K to kill it this time. Bunny reveals its enormous fangs, but you kill it before it can bite you. Here we go. My score is now 10 because I have a score of 5 here, and I've just added another 5 here. Okay, let's just check the last one as well. This time we're going to run, so we're going to press R. The bunny's quicker than it looks. Before you know it, it hops onto you with those enormous fangs and bites your head off. Two knives left and the score is 5. So those both work. Excellent. So, continue your game. Add another scenario, a third scenario, and either use an if and an else, or an if, elif, or an else, or if you're feeling really adventurous, have more than one elif in the middle here. Just follow the same pattern. Start with if, then elif, then another elif, and then an else to have more than three options. Choice of what happens in the story is entirely up to you. See you.